So what's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to Relation Programming with ST.V. In this class we're going to see how to sort a list view in both, of course, alphabetically in an ascending, both ascending as well as descending manner. So of course right here, in fact, let me just kill the application first, then we start it from scratch. Okay, I now come here. Yeah, I have it right here. Then of course by default is actually not sorted, as you guys can see it's not sorted. So we're going to sort it, okay? Top group sort in both ascending as well as descending manner. So these are our data. Now I come click toggle sort. First it sorts it, of course, in an ascending manner from A all the way to W, okay? So from Andromeda all the way to Whirlpool. Now if I come click toggle sort, it's going to toggle the sort from the Whirlpool all the way to Andromeda. This is what we're going to look at right here, guys. Of course, how to sort. So join me, we get started. So guys, first and foremost we're going to look at what sorting is actually, okay? And we're going to first of course give the definition and a brief description of what we actually mean by sorting. So what is sorting? Well, of course, sorting is basically the process of arranging data into meaningful order, okay, so that the analysis of that data can be more effective. So of course it's a common operation in many applications, and in fact we talked about this one when we're discussing how to sort using grid view. So there are actually algorithms out there that have been developed to provide these type of capabilities, okay, the sorting capabilities to various data structures. So let's look at some of the common types of sorting. Well, of course we have right here the sorting strings into alphabetical order. That's a very, very common one. For example, from A to Z and from Z to A, okay, alphabetically. Now we can, in fact, that's what we're going to do in this class. We're going to sort our data alphabetically from in ascending, that is from A to Z, and then in a descending from Z to A. Then sorting numerical data into numerical order. That's also a common type of sorting where you actually basically sort numbers. Well, there's also the group sorting data to many levels, okay? You have like sorting your data according to groups or categories. Now what are the advantages of sorting data? Well, first of course it makes it easier for us as well as the computers to analyze data, okay? Now sorted data is also easier on the eye than unsorted data. So just by looking at, of course, a sorted data, we can actually be able to get exactly what we want, okay? Because we can just intuitively infer where the data that you actually want is. Then of course sorting data makes the following efficient. First, it makes searching data or filtering or looking up data efficient. Sorting data also makes merging sequences of data efficient, okay? For example, say you have two collections and you actually want to merge them into one. Now sorted data will be easier and more efficient. Then of course data processing of data is also more efficient with sorted data. So of course computers can better process sorted data than unsorted data, okay, more efficiently than unsorted data. So yeah, those are the three things that sorting data of makes efficient. And of course the opposite of sorting is actually shuffling, okay, shuffling of data. So it's basically the process by which you rearrange a sequence of items in a random manner. So by default majority of data is normally in a shuffled state, okay, it's not sorted. Now after this one, of course now it's actually time, let's go write some example in of course our project. So go ahead, type your application name, then of course come, I'm going to go with the PI14. Then of course I'm going to choose the empty activity, then you click next, then of course you click finish to generate for us our project. So first and foremost is our project structure. Under the manifest we have 100 manifest.xml. There's really nothing special we do right here. Then of course inside our build.cradle, the module app, you can see what we have right here. We don't have of course any third-party library that we are adding in our dependencies. Now once we have that one, then we're going to come to our layout. activity main.xml, this is our layout. So clearly you can see inside our layout at the root we are having the relative layout. So relative layout. Then we have our text view, which is our header right here. Okay, we're going to have it into all caps. Okay, then inside right here we also have our button, the toggle sort button. Then we have our list view below it. So our list is going to match parent both in both width as well as the height. Okay, now that's what you're going to have. Of course, next let's go ahead move over to our main activity, the Java. So here's our main activity. The first thing of course is to specify our package. Then we come right here, we create the class. Of course, an activity is basically a class that does derive from android.app.activity. Now here's our imports. One of course android.app.activity is one of them. So we're going to make our main activity derive from android.app.activity. So this far our main activity is now an activity. Okay, so yeah, we come right here, we're going to create as its instance fields. First we're going to have a list view, so we'll have a list view. Then our button, my sort button. So this is the button that will be used for sorting our data. Then we come right here, we're going to have a string. Okay, this is a string array, so we're calling it galaxies. It's going to contain our galaxies, which is going to act as our data source. So a string array is what we're actually using as our galaxy, as our data source. Okay, then we're going to have right here a sort ascending. We're going to set it as true is a boolean. Then of course a private boolean, unsorted equal to true. So by default, the first time we click our sort button, our sort ascending will be true, and the first time of course we run our project, our data will be in unsorted mode. Now we come, we're going to create a simple method called initialize views. This method will first initialize our my list view by finding it by its ID from our layout specification. Then we'll go ahead, instantiate our array adapter, then set it as an set it of course inside our set adapter method. Then we'll go ahead, my sort button equal to find view by ID, r.id dot my sort button. Then we'll go set on click listener for our button. Then of course when clicked, we're going to invoke a method called sort data. Now sort data will come define it right here. The first thing inside the sort data method is that we're going to instantiate, no, in fact obtain a list from our array. So arrays dot as list, this is the method we're using. You can see we pass in an array and then it gives us a generic list of type string. Okay, a list of generic type string right here, which we have as our galaxies list. Now we come and say if unsorted, then collections.sort, we pass in our galaxies list. Okay, otherwise else collections.reverse galaxies list. Clearly, as you can see, first our data will be in unsorted mode the first time we run the project. Well, we're just going to call collections.sort to sort that data. Now subsequently, if the user clicks the button, the toggle button, we're going to be toggling it by just reversing the already sorted data. Now of course to do that, one also need to come right here and set our sort ascending to not sort ascending. Okay, so sort ascending equal to not sort ascending, basically sort ascending equal to descending. Okay, so we're basically toggling between ascending and descending by just negating the value that we have in our sort ascending variable. So if it was ascending, we'll negate it to descending. If it was descending, we're going to negate to ascending. Then of course we set our unsorted to false, such that this right here, this condition right here, will only get executed once. Our data will only be in unsorted mode once only after we've run the project. Well, then my listview.set adapter, then we pass in the instance of our array adapter. Well, we go ahead, override our onCreate method. So inside the onCreate method, this is what we're going to do first. We're going to set our content view, r.layout.activityMain. Then we'll go ahead, call initialize views. Well, that's all we need to do. Let's now go ahead, then run our project, and of course, see our result. Okay, so if we run the project, this is what we're getting right here. You can see, of course, our list view is not sorted, our data is not sorted. So we go click the sort button, and clearly you can see we're able to sort this particular data, okay, Andromeda all the way to our all the way to Whirlpool right here, and then toggle sort. We are able to also toggle it in a descending manner, okay, so from Whirlpool all the way to Andromeda. Guys, this is what we've looked at right here, okay. So like the video shade, we're going to attach the source code in our website https camposha.info. Take care, I'll catch you in the next class.